It's a mix because what you're getting from all the places is all different. Radio's great. I've been doing radio for years. I'm doing TV now. The vibes is just different. Stage is different too. So how am I going to say I want to choose one? Let's just stick to the first love. Radio is fantastic because, you know, you're just talking to people you cannot see, but it's like surreal. It's like living in a mystery world. So that really appeals. It does appeal. Though the appeal is gone now when you go on TV. So, I just say radio. My first time on radio would be with Radio 1, Federal Radio Corporation of Nigeria. Yes, that's where I started my radio journey. And it was not nice at all. I was just shaking, I was sweating. Dude, it was a microphone, but it felt scary. Like, oh God, what am I going to say? If I say something wrong, I'm just going to get everybody not to like me. And you can't go to everybody and say, oh, please, can I bring that back? My first day was really not nice. I think I worked with Cordelia Okwe. Yes, she's in Radio Nigeria. And she's one of those people that taught us the ropes. She just put me on the spot and just asked me a question about some tribe in Ghana. And I didn't know who they were. It was not nice at all, believe me. I hated it. You know, I've been doing radio for a couple of years. Oga Madam Live on Stage started about, this year will be the fourth edition, holding on the 1st of November. And I've been doing radio for like 8 years with Wazobia FM. And you know, I have a lot of humor inside me. So I started to say, okay, why don't I just start to, you know, scratch the surface of stand-up comedy, skits on stage, you know, things that has to do with the stage. So I conceptualized it and said, okay, I want to take the best part of my show on radio and put it on stage for people to just be able to feel the vibes, what they hear on radio, on stage. So the dream started about 4 years ago, and I think it's been getting better ever since. I wouldn't say I was doing stand-up comedy. I was a professional MC. Of course, I do. I compare events. I've been doing that for years. I can't even remember the first event I ever did. I've been MCing, basically. Of course, I bring humor. But I think when I started doing Oga Madam Live on Stage is when I started to do stand-up comedy. It's all about passion. If you have a passion for something, of course, I always strive to excel at anything I do. I want to be the best at it. It's not easy, but of course, if it's something you're passionate about, you're going to be able to find a way to keep it going. And every year, you can tell me there are no new materials. Things are happening every day. And of course, that makes it fresh, that makes it nice, and that makes it very unique. This year's edition is called The Queen on Rampage. That's the theme of the event, Oga Madam Live Season 4. This year, I'm going to be doing everything I know how to do. That means I'm going to be singing. I'm going to be dancing. I've been working seriously on some Mexican dance. I hope I can pull it off. I'm really hoping I can pull it off. Of course, stand-up comedy is going to be there. And there's going to be live skits on stage also. Dance. It's just like watching like a musical opera. It's going to be a beautiful experience. Yeah, you know, every woman these days, we're all pushing the envelopes of everything that we do. And I'm saying like, okay, last year the queen was defined. It was called the definition of a queen. Okay, when you come of age, you're defined. But now, I just want to scatter everywhere and just leave my pieces everywhere I go. So it's like the queen on rampage. So it depends on what part of me hits you. It could be the comedy part. It could be the music part. It could be the acting part. Anything that hits you. The queen is displaying. She's just throwing herself everywhere. So just catch what you can.
It just sounds like a bag of surprises.
Oh yeah, I love my head is like drama. If you live in my head, you probably shoot yourself because it's crazy. Relevant. You know, women in the industry, they're not so many. I can count them off my fingers. But you know, it's not like they're not women that are doing the same things. But you know, it takes courage to be able to stand and do what you think men do excellently. But I've seen women do better than a lot of men. The only thing is that we have a lot of more things that we do alongside comedy. So you'll probably not see a woman that has children or has a home that wants to stay on stage half of the time and travel and do tours, except it's planned out. So maybe that's why it's a little challenging for women just to stay there. You can call a guy and say, okay, come and compare an event in Uyo. But a woman, you have to be thinking of a lot of other things before you can just get and go. Maybe that's why. But keeping our head up, women are bringing their game. Princess is strong. Mandy is great. Ellen Paul. We have Chi Girl. And of course, Sam Lepash's boss. I think they're doing good, every one of us. You know, Nigerians, I want to call us hypocrites sometimes, because the things that we really like are those things that you don't want to talk about. So that's one. But societally, you know, there's some things that we don't tolerate culture-based, because we're Africans and we like to hide in our closets about what we really, who we really are. It's just the times. I just believe that every stage you're on, you have to understand what I call the science of the stage. You have to know what jokes work somewhere. Maybe some sleazy jokes can work in beer parlors, comedy clubs, that you willfully go. But when you do like a major show that is a mix of people, I think you want to just keep it, you know, at a particular level. And but some people have grown to understand some brands, that this is what they bring. And they don't lie about it. If you want to come and watch a show titled Uncensored, then that means you told me that you can take it. So I don't want you howling. I don't want you shouting. I don't want you screaming. They told you, it's not a, it's like my event, I always tell people, it's not for children. I'm a mom. I expect my kids to be in, my kids are always in bed by 8:30. So I cannot take them to a comedy show at night. I don't get it. So if you're coming for a show, I say, I'm going to say everything raw. Or just like saying Lolo1 raw and naked. And you want to tell me you don't know what I'm saying? Then if you came to the show, then you know what I'm bringing. So I don't want you to, you know, go all on me. That kind of thing. Everywhere. There's jokes in everything. Everybody jokes about something. Every time you look at yourself, there's always something to laugh about. It's just that we Africans, Nigerians in particular, you can make a joke out of anything that you see. I could just look at someone and say, wow, gone at the era of this laptop, I see Oga nice on his Apple, you know, iPad, feeling all fly. But there was a time that our great-grandfathers used to read the Bible. That was all they had. And of course, we'll spit on our fingers to move everything, because they will stick together. That's fun. Imagine giving his grandfather this particular laptop, and the guy keeps seeing this thing sliding. Of course, he's going to naturally want to put his hand to the mouth, spit on it, and just strike. Ah, say, omo mi kiri, yo move for balesin, say, she go gomuni. You know, that's just one thing. You know, some people just tell me that, okay, yesterday Alibaba, sometime ago, Alibaba had spontaneity, and he had jokes about everything. I'm looking at your shoes now, and I can say, ah, gone are those days when we used to wear cortina. Those shoes have seen better days. But this is your shoe, be like saying that your grandfather important, because this shoe and cortina, it looks the same. You know, baby girl, I don't know what you're pushing. You see, you could just make jokes out of everything. Imagine this camera before me. I could just sit and say, remember those days that they used to say, watch the bed. I had to wait for like 15 seconds for the picture to take. Of course, it's going to come out very starchy and very, like, statue. That's why you see our fathers go like, they've been sitting for like 15 seconds for the thing to snap, watching the bird. See, I made a joke about everything that I can just visibly see. So that's how life is. Where, like, everything, you can just make humor out of it. Babes, believe me, that's the scary part, you know. Here in Nigeria, I'm a lawyer by training. I'm 15 years post-call. So I know what it means to say you have copyright. In my project, I wrote about the neighboring rights, which is the performer's right. We are not at that level yet that we understand. We know it head, you know, there's some things you just know head value. But intellectual property is your intellect. It's just like stealing somebody's blazer. It belongs to that person. But here, you know, it's like a free-for-all market. So everybody can just tell anybody's jokes. There are no boundaries, no structure. So I think that's going to keep happening until things are a bit structured, that you can get penalized or punished or even go to jail for telling somebody's joke without permission. Without permission. So when you see maybe younger comedians, I hardly comment in Nigeria. Most of the times I do real stand up is either out of the country, I'm a little more comfortable. Because here, I do spontaneous jokes, just like I did now. Jokes about what I can see. I might not be able to tell you a story of how my father used to have a poor house, the rats used to chase us, all those things. But I will tell you things that are to me now. That means my own jokes are fresh. And somebody can just take it and I won't even know it's mine. You know, that kind of thing. So I believe that maybe as we grow, the industry will keep getting better and structures will be in place. One fear I had to overcome. A lot of, at the beginning of my life, you know, I didn't come to myself until I was a little older. I used to have major self-esteem issues about how you look visibly. And most of the time I used to believe that I wasn't good enough to be at a certain place or because I look a certain way. But it's a fear I had to overcome because now I mentor women that have low self-esteem issues because it's one of the things that debilitate you. It's like, for me, it's like a cancer. It just kills you. Some of the wrong choices I've made in my life, I made when my head was in that place and they were wrong for me. So overcoming how you look was one of the biggest fears I had to overcome. Now I'm very into myself. I know who I am. I know how good I am. I even know how pretty I am. And I see that there is diversity in everything God has created. So that's why women can't look the same. It's impossible. Nobody can get a Nicki Minaj body without buying it. Forget it. All those things are Photoshop. Wow, this year, a lot of people will say, okay, Lolo, I need to put my name in the mark. So for people, when they're talking about stand-up comedians, they need to hear me. A lot of people say, okay, Lolo, I know her on radio. She's funny. But now you want to see me on stage. If you've ever watched me, you'll know that I'm someone you want to watch. And the next, I don't like to say the next big thing because big thing can be relative. So this year is going to be fun. A lot of artists are going to be there. Industry players are going to be there. And I'm doing everything to make sure that it's a very tight show. And everybody that comes would have a great, I always call it the pre to Christmas. So you're going to be having Christmas in November. My name is Omotunde Lolo1. Five comedians I'm feeling right now. Of course, I'm going to have to doff my hat to the grandfather himself, Ali Baba. He never fails. It's like someone you call is like a demigod when it comes to comedy. Pick him out today is great. Ali Baba. I'm going to give it to Bovi. Why? Because Bovi is extremely intelligent. There are not many comedians that are cut in that cloth. So he's one of those people that have that. So number three, I'm going to have to give it to this guy called Acapella. One of the most amazing comedians I've heard in a long, 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 long time. He's absolutely amazing. I like him. I like his stuff. I like everything he does. I'm going to give it to Bash. I like Bash because he's very real, very original, very local. You know, I like it when your creativity, you can tell where it's from. And I love Sheyi Law. I know this list is short. I know this list is short, but I kind of just call everybody. Why I would choose Sheyi Law? Sheyi Law is just a man that gets on stage and is just himself. A lot of people get there and you start to want to be like someone else. He brings his Yoruba and there is no harm. There is no gain saying. You just take it or you leave it. I think they're great comedians, really. All the people I mentioned, I personally love them. My name is Omotunde Lolo1. All of you call me that. And of course, it's a nice place to be. I'm on Pulse TV, so you should be watching them. Of course, be on it, you know, celebrate this.